when I'm in a normal electric car, or if we're using a normal space heater at home and we plug this space heater into the wall outlet, if I am cold and I want to get 100 watts of heat out, I expect to draw about 100 watts of power from the wall. And so engineers define this term called coefficient of performance, or COP, to define a quantity of what do we want versus how much do we have to pay for it. And so I wanted 100 watts of heat, and I had to pay about 100 watts of power to PG&E, or my electric provider. And so my COP equals 100 over 100, which is just about one. And so at the end of the day, that's how it usually works in most electric cars. What Tesla was able to do with their Model Y is make use of a heat pump in order to achieve a coefficient of performance of 3. And this is very interesting because what this is telling us is that somehow, by getting that same 100 watts of power out of the car, I'm only having to put in 33 watts from my battery. So, are we somehow breaking the laws of physics here? The answer is no, but there's some really cool engineering that's happening behind the scenes inside of these Tesla Model Ys. And so, what's happening inside of a heat pump is you are taking a low pressure, low temperature gas, and this gas, which I'll denote as just this bar right here, is entering a unit that is called a compressor. The compressor has the job of basically turning this low temperature, low pressure gas into a high pressure, high temperature gas. And so what we're going to do is, after we've compressed this gas and made it hot, is we're going to stick it into our condenser. And so inside of your car's cabin, you will have a condenser, and this condenser is taking this really hot gas and allowing the thermal energy of these gas molecules to enter the cabin to get me that 100 watts of heat that I asked for. And so the Tesla's battery is putting in the 33 watts of work right here at the condenser to compress this gas, to get its temperature up, to get its pressure up, and then we're putting it into this condenser where I'm getting my 100 watts of heat out. And so once I've got my 100 watts of thermal energy from this gas, what's going to happen next is, because these gas molecules have just given up their energy, they're going to turn into a liquid. They're going to condense. They're going to turn from the vapor phase into a liquid phase because they don't have enough thermal energy to be excited enough to exist in the vapor phase anymore. And so what we have now is a liquid, and this liquid is going to get piped into something that's called an expansion valve. These expansion valves, which is this purple thing right here, have the job of decreasing the pressure on this fluid. And so they do it by basically expanding everything, creating a lot more volume. The new excess of volume creates a low pressure environment where this is more conducive for having these things turn into gas again. So you've got this liquid, you want to get this liquid back into the vapor phase. You do it by first decreasing the pressure using an expansion valve. What happens next in this process is that you're going to take the low pressure stream of fluid that you have and then pass it through your evaporator. And so in the evaporator, the energy from the outside is going to go into this evaporator in order to help these molecules in this stream of fluid right here that want to turn into a gas get that thermal energy to be a gas again. And so in Tesla's case, or in a heat pump's case, this evaporator is on the outside of the actual car. And so what we're doing is we're taking the thermal energy from the outside world and using it to heat up the stuff that's going to be heating me up inside of my car. And so in the case of the Tesla, what we have here is 67 watts of thermal energy from the outside world going into this fluid right now. And then what we're going to have is it turning into a low pressure, low temperature gas. This low temperature, low pressure gas will then link up with our condenser, or I'm sorry, our compressor. And then inside this compressor, our car will be supplying the 33 watts of energy needed to basically drive this cycle and keep it going. So to recap, by only investing 33 watts of power from your car's battery, you're able to get 100 watts of heat into your car, because you are making up for that other 67 watts by taking it from the outside world in your evaporator. So this is some really interesting stuff that makes the Tesla Model Y and its heat pump really cool. I believe the Nissan Leaf was another electric car that has this similar design, but it shows us why you can pay a lot less energy and still get decent performance and even better performance from our cars. They'll let us get better ranges and still deliver the same quality of heat that we expect from an automobile in the 21st century. So really, really cool and exciting stuff. And I want to thank Engineering Explained for kind of bringing this out and publishing stuff that I think is really cool. Let me know if you have any questions. Thank you all for watching. Please stay safe, wash your hands, wear masks, and I'll talk to you next time.